Hello, and welcome to another Scriptcase tutorial. Today we're going to be looking at using multiple databases so that you can accommodate multiple companies with a single application. My name is Nate Carpenter, and I'm the Scriptcase instructor leading this tutorial. So I hope this is helpful for you. Let's go ahead and let's do some preliminary work so you can kind of understand a little bit better of how this process and this flow is going to work. I've got here just a very basic flow chart here, and it's nothing fancy, and it's probably not a perfect flow chart, but hopefully if maybe this is a way that you learn, this will be helpful for you. So up here at the top, we have your app. This is whatever, and we're going to be using the app that we created for the multiple languages tutorial. So you can see a little bit more of how that was built in the last video. But you have your app, and then for that application, you have a single security system. So you don't have a multiple security systems for each client. You have just one, and that security system is then going to control which database your client's users can access. So you have all these clients. So let's see, you have three companies, company A, company B, and company C. And each of those companies then has their own database. And then each of those companies also has their own users, as you can see here. So this is just very basic, and I'm sorry, it's not too fancy of a flowchart here. And the way we're going to develop this is when the user logs into your application, it's going to use the same security system, and we're going to use that security system, we're going to augment it just a little bit, to tell us which database that user is associated with. So we can associate it with a single database, so when it logs it in, we can switch it out to a different database, and so that they can see the correct data for the company which they are a customer of. So hopefully that makes a little bit of sense, but if it doesn't, don't worry, I'll show you all how it works. So as I said, we're going to be using the system that we used for the multiple languages tutorial. So I'd encourage you to go back and watch that if you want to see a little bit more of how that was designed and laid out. We don't go through the whole development process there, but you might understand it a little bit better. We're not going to spend too much time explaining how it works since I did that in the last video. And today we're just going to focus on the important aspect of how to switch out these database connections. So let's get started with this and let's look at the Scriptcase documentation for how this is done. Okay, so here we are in the Scriptcase documentation and we're looking at a specific macro here, the SC connection edit macro. And for that, we need a connection name and an array of settings that we're going to change. So there's the connection name that we're going to be changing. And then we need to pass in the settings that we want to change. And it has here all the settings that we can give it. We're really only concerned about three. There's several here, but we're really only concerned about the server, username, password, and database. Actually, we're not concerned about the server at all. And there's an example of how it can be done. And we're going to copy this example almost exactly. And it's going to give us what we need to do. So let's go over to Scriptcase now. And here is that project that I mentioned earlier that we created in the last tutorial. And we just have a very basic form and a grid for an actor table. Let's go and look at our database setup. So let's go to Database and Database Builder. And this is going to show us a little bit more. So as you can see, we have two connections here, a CUST connection and a security connection. This CUST connection is going to be the main connection that we're going to swap out using the SC connection edit macro right there. And that's going to contain the user's data. Then we have the security connection in addition to the CUST connection. The security connection is just one, and we're not going to swap it out with any other databases. And we augmented this a little bit. So here are the tables that are included in the security module, but we've added two tables, the security databases and security databases group. The databases table, if we click on that, contains an ID and then the name, the user, and the password for that. So those are those three variables that we're going to need to edit the connection right there in that example. So we save those in the database so we can pull them out whenever we need them. And then if we go back here and we look at the security databases groups. So we need to link the groups table with the databases table. And we do that with the security databases groups table here. So this is the second table that I added. And the SQL for this will be included in the link below. And here we just have the group ID and the database ID. So that'll tell us which group goes with which database. So we only have one database that goes with each user group. So if we select the data for this, we can see that there's two groups here, 3 and 4, that are connected to database 1 and 2. So now let's look at our databases table. So let me select that here and then select the data. Okay, so there are two databases here, films and films2, with the usernames and the passwords all in there. So those are going to be our two databases. One of them is the main one, and then the second one, films2, is just an empty database. It has the same structure, but it's completely empty. So our database is all set up. Now we just need to set up our applications so that they can switch databases. So we really only need to edit the login application. This is very simple. So we're going to open that up, and we need to understand a little bit of how the user is authenticated inside of this login application. This is just a control application, so it just can execute some code based on a form. So we're looking at events here, and let's look at the onValidateSuccess event. So this is after everything is validated, and we know that they entered a username and a password, and that user exists. Now we just need to log them in. So we execute that function there, scValidateSuccess. And if we go under the blue tab programming in PHP methods over here on the left, we can find that scValidateSuccess function right there. If you see it right there, click on that, and let's see the code for that. So this is setting all the permissions for the session, for this user's session. So it figures out what permissions they have from the security group's apps there based on the group ID for that login. And that's determined in the onValidate event right there. And then it goes through each of those there, and it sets them in the session here. So it sets them in a big array, and then it sets them in the session right here. The SCAPL comp is setting those permissions for those apps. And then it logs the login, and then it redirects to the menu so that the user can begin using the application. We're going to insert a little bit of code right here to kind of add on to this. So we need that group ID first. That's the first thing we need to do. So we're going to execute a query to get that group ID based on that user login. So let me copy some code right here. There we go. And there is our query. So we're getting the group ID from our security users groups table there in the security database, where the login equals the user login that we just authenticated them as. Executing that query, and then getting the result out of RS and saving it into that variable right there. So now that we know the group ID, we know which database they should access. So let me copy a little bit more code in here. So we need to execute another query to get the database credentials that they need to access the correct database. So we're pulling from that security databases table and the security databases groups here. So we're doing a left join on the databases groups and the databases table. Setting that as D, we're getting the name, the user, and the pass. So those, again, all those three variables that we need there. The name is going to be the database option. That's the name of the database. And then we're left joining it to our security databases groups on the group ID equals that group ID that we pulled out. So that's going to be DG, linking it based on database ID there, and then limiting it based on the group ID for that user. And then we just execute the query here, and we have our data. Now we need to copy this code here and modify it to work with the data that we got from the query. So let me copy it here, and I'm going to paste it right below. Okay, so we set up that array connections right there. That's going to be the settings. And then we're going to set the user equal to the username that we got out of that query. So it's going to be from the RS variable there. And this is a index here. So the first array, we're just getting one row out of this. And then the second element of that is going to be the user, because that's the item we pulled out. So that's index of one because it's zero based. And let me copy that for the second item here for password. That's going to be the third item, and it's zero based, so it's index two. And then the last one is the name of the database. So that's the first one we pulled out, so that's going to be index 0, like so. And then our array is all set up to be passed in right there to the connection edit. Now we just need to give it the connection name. Let's go to database and edit connection. And we see there that is the connection we want to edit. We name that cust. We name that when we created the connection inside of Scriptcase. And that is the name it needs. So we name it cust like so. So we tell it to edit that one, and let's go ahead and hit save on this. And we've got one more thing I forgot to do. Down here at the bottom here, this RS needs to be surrounded by curly braces. That way Scriptcase knows it's one of its variables. So let me just copy that for all of these, and then it should run correctly without any errors. So let's go ahead and run this, and this should work and swap out the database underneath us. Okay, wait for it to generate and load here. Okay, so here is our login application that we built last time with the languages demo. And let's look at our database here just to remind ourselves of this different data. So if we look here in the groups table, we have two groups here that we are concerned about, the films group and the films 2 group. So those are our two databases. So that's group ID 3 and 4. We go to our databases groups. We have group ID 3 and 4 linked to database 1 and 2. And then our databases table. Database 1 is the films 1 and database 2 is the films 2 1. And then we have users over here that are linked to those groups. The films 2 user and the films user. So if we log in with the films user, we get our main films database, and the films 2 user will log us into our films 2 database. So let's go ahead and log in here with the films 1. And this is kind of our control case. If we load actor here, there's our main database right there like we would expect. Now I don't have the login out option selected for this, but let's go ahead and run our login application again so it'll log us out. And let's log in as our films 2 user. So enter the credentials for our films 2 user here. And this is going to access our empty database. So the structure is the same, but there isn't any data in it. So when we load actor here, all logged in, and when we load our actor form, we should get no records. And there we go, there are no records. So let's add a new one here for a new actor. So this is in our empty database. We're going to create our first record. Tom Cruise, click add on that. And it should add it, click cancel, and there is our new actor that we added. So that's how you access multiple databases inside of Scriptcase. It's very easy. Once you do that in the login application, it'll set the database for the entirety of the user's session. So it's all set up across all their applications and ready to go. So I hope this is helpful for you. I hope this is very useful and you can use it in your own applications. And I'll see you in the next tutorials.